Welcome, Year 7s. This is the first time you've ever seen the Careers Assembly. And what this does is promote our ethos, Skills for Life. And what that means is we want you to be armed with the various skills that you will need in the outside world. That could be listening, it could be contributing to lessons, it could be debating, it could be being resilient, so learning how to lose and celebrating when you win. All those different types of skills. And with that, we want to arm you with career information. We want you to know from a very young age what careers are out there, and prospectively, so that you can work through school and aim for that career. For those of you, and there are photography students in here, so welcome. This should be of massive interest to you, because I'm really proud and pleased to announce Tommy Reynolds is coming today, who owns Tommy Reynolds Photography. Tommy is not only a successful businessman, a successful entrepreneur, he's going to go red now, an amazing photographer, he's also one of our own. He's an ex-pupil of Greenacre and an ex-sixth-former who went, like you lot, I sat through probably with Mr. Thompson and going through and did his photography A-level here. So this really can give you an idea as to where you can take these qualifications. Without further ado, I'm going to hand over to Tommy. Please give him your full respect and attention, and any questions can be invited at the end. Thanks very much.
No worries. Good morning, guys. Thanks very much for that. As she said, my name is Tommy Reynolds and I'm a portrait and commercial photographer, and I'm also a music video director. I've been freelancing now for about 2 years since leaving university, and I want to show you a quick showreel of some of the, you're seeing some of my photography, but I want to show you some of my video work that I also do as well. So here's a showreel of some stuff that I've been doing recently. I apologise, there's a bit of a lag there. But in the very short 2 years that I've been a freelancer, I've been extremely lucky to have worked with clients such as these, including Psycho Music, Sony Music, Universal Music. So mainly working with music distributors, as well as people like Ben Sherman and some of the biggest acts I've worked with. I've directed UB40's music video, worked with Pixie Lott and Boyce Avenue, the biggest bands on YouTube at the moment. But going back to the beginning of when I used to be here, I picked media and photography, of course. And I remember when I first picked media, I originally picked it because I thought it was going to be a bit of a DOS. And I'm sure that other people may have thought the same thing, and the same with photography as well. I thought, well, it's got to be easier than maths, surely. But I did media, and I did it with Mr. Batchelor, who is still here, which I think is an absolutely amazing teacher. I really, really appreciate his time. And I remember in the first few lessons with Mr. Batchelor, The Sixth Sense was the first movie we watched, and learning about stuff like the iconographic objects in that, how the color red was an association with danger and death, and how using a high angle shot, for example, looking down on someone can make them feel small and subordinate and weak. And the opposite of a house on top of a hill, for example, can make them look strong and empowering and dominant. And just the psychology of that, of you taking that in subliminal, just fascinated me to think that you can look at film in a completely different way like that. And I just thought, that's really interesting. It made me appreciate watching films a lot more, knowing that, if that makes sense. And the same with photography. But with photography, it was more of an artistic approach. So when I left, I wanted to learn more about the technicality of photography. But I wanted to actually show you, going back to media very quickly, when I was here, I've managed to find the very first, or the very last film that I made while I was here. And you'll probably recognize some of the things around. So let me just skip to that. So this was that I made, it was a music video that you had to make. I'll just show you a little extract from it. This is so cringing. Yeah, I'm not gonna show you anymore because that's really cringing. So I like to think that I've improved in the last few years. Mr. White's looking at me like, no, you haven't. But I left here 10 years ago now, and I did sixth form here, so 7 years ago now. God, that makes me feel old. So when I left sixth form, I went on to university. I went to the University of Greenwich. At the time, I was more into filming, so I studied TV and film production. But whilst I was at university, I was photographing bands. And this was kind of my first step into doing photography, kind of semi-pro. I became known as the local band photographer because a lot of bands in Medway were doing gigs in and around Medway in like Command House or Raffle Club or other sort of pubs. As well as that, I was also heavily involved in a fantastic youth organisation called Training Them Live, which unfortunately ended this year. But that gave me a tremendous opportunity to use my skill and to use my camera to actually go out there and use it and develop my skills. So I have a huge thank you to Dan Wise and Training Them Live for that. If it wasn't for you, Dan, I wouldn't be standing here right now. So I thank you tremendously for that. Thank you very much. So while I was at university, as I said, I was photographing bands and it gave me a huge confidence boost doing photography and working with bands. It just gave, because I had an excuse hanging from my shoulder. I had to walk right up to someone and say, hey, my name's Tommy, I just photographed your band. Here are some of the shots I took. You're welcome to use them. Just make sure you give me a mention maybe on Facebook or anything like that. And that's how it went from there. And then I just became known as the local band photographer. So then eventually I would start saying, oh, guys, would you mind paying me a little bit of expenses? So you just kind of build it up from there. So if you can just build up a little reputation within your local community for what you do, if you're into band photography, then it's a great way to start. Band photography is a great way. Everyone knows someone in a band. So you can just go up and just offer your services for free and get your name out there. And that's the most important thing, is networking and getting your name, your brand, your establishment out there. Let's take that off. I'll just cycle through that. So when I came to the end of university, I was getting more back into my photography. So when I left university, I got a job working at Jessup's in Bluewater. I worked there for about a year as a team leader. And after a year, am I done? Okay, sorry. After a year of working at Jessup's, it unfortunately went into administration and I was forced out of the job. And I said to myself, when I leave Jessup's, I'm not going to I'm not going to get another job in retail. I want to do this full time. And when I was forced into administration, I just thought to myself, okay, I'm just going to go at this, and I just hit the floor running. And I was very naive at the start. Unfortunately, 80% of a business, what I learned then, is doing the other bits. It's all the taxing and the invoicing and all the kind of boring stuff. And 20% is really doing the bit that you actually like. And that's what I didn't realize at the start as a freelancer, knowing that. But so at the start, so I would make business cards, I made flyers, I put a suit on, I walked up and down Rochester and Chatham High Street. I was walking into local businesses saying, hey, my name's Tommy. I'm a local photographer. If you need any photos, let me know. I'd walk into floristries. I'd walk into hairdressers and offer my services just to try and get my name out there, and going around to other bands and say, I'm gonna ask for a little bit more money if that's okay, guys, because this is now my job. This is now my full-time job. And they completely understood that, which I was very thankful for. Just check my notes. Yes, that's it. Sorry. So whilst I was shooting bands, the way I got to work with other higher profile celebrities, I just kind of, people ask, like, what was your big break? And there isn't really a big break for most people. It's kind of a gradual incline. And there was a show last year called, Rochester Castle Gardens. And my friend Jamie Johnson was supporting, who you may know from BBC's The Voice. So he was performing along with a band called Jackpack, who are managed by Simon Cowell's label, Psycho. And I took the initiative after I photographed my friend Jamie. I thought, well, whilst I'm backstage, I might as well photograph the other acts, and one of which was Jackpack, which I did photograph. And I walked right up to the manager and said, hey, my name's Tommy. I just took some shots of Jackpack for you. You're welcome to have them. And he said, oh, these are great. We'd love to work with you again. So after that, I had a couple more paid jobs with them, and then he offered me a retainership. And now I work with Psycho, and I know that Simon Cowell has one of my images printed on his office wall that I took of Jackpack, which is a huge testimonial for me. And and those trousers really are that high. They're definitely that high. what else? The way I worked with Pixie Lott and the Vamps was, I went to a YouTube event, and the Vamps were there and their cinematographer was there. And I just got to chatting with him, and I just said, oh, well, if you need a second shooter, then let me know. I showed him some of my work. He really liked it, and then thought nothing of it for a while. And then he tweeted something. His name's Dean Sherwood, the cinematographer. And I thought nothing of it. And when he tweeted, I tweeted him back saying, hey, just to remind you, if you need me, let me know. And he tweeted me back saying, ring me now, and left me his number. I rung him and he said, you tweeted me at the right time, because I am just looking for a second shooter. I'm doing some filming with the boys next week, and their special guest is Pixie Lott. Do you want to come and do it? I was like, yeah, sure. Which was absolutely amazing. So this is the power of social media. And this is, I believe that you got to put as much work in school as you have outside of school. I believe it's 50-50. It's what you make of it. You got to take your skill, and you got to just, if you've got the skill now, if you're really into photography, if you really are passionate about photography, start building your portfolio up now. Don't wait until you finish school. Don't wait until you finish uni, because this unfortunate, sad truth is, after uni, it doesn't come to you. You've still got to go out there, and you've still got to get the work yourself. You know, my university degree didn't walk up to Jackpack's manager and say, here's some images. I took that initiative. You've got to take that initiative, and you've got to run with it, okay? If you've got that passion, then prove it to me and show me your work, because I want to see your work later on, okay? I'll leave you my email if any of you want to contact me about anything that I've talked about today. I've really sped through this quickly. That's another thing as well. Another way to get yourself out there is work with charities. If you work, as I said before, you've got to offer yourself for free first. You've got to offer them something. That's how I worked with Jackpack. I offered myself free first, and then when he came back to me, then we were able to negotiate pricing. And that's not the only person I've been able to get work with shooting the support acts. if you are doing band photography, shoot the support acts. Even so, you've not been asked to shoot the support acts, you've been asked to shoot the main acts probably, but still shoot the support acts, because you never know where those support acts might take you. And one of which was when I was photographing Boyce Avenue. As I said, they're currently the biggest YouTube band. They've just hit 2 billion views. And the way I got to work with them initially was way back in the day when they weren't as famous. I contacted the lead singer on his Facebook and just said, hey, see you're in London for the first time. I've been a fan of yous for a while. I'd love to come and shoot you. He replied within 15 minutes saying, absolutely, that'd be great. And then fast forward 3 years and I asked if I could photograph them again. They were back in London. And he said, you know what, we love your work so much, we would love you to come on tour with us. So that's how I started becoming their European tour photographer back in 2012 through to 13. And their support act at the time was a guy called Nick Howard, and he won The Voice, but he won the German version, season two. And I photographed him as well, didn't ask me to, but I just did it anyway, sent him the pictures, he really liked them, and I've now been on a German tour with him. I've shot 3 of his official music videos, and he invited me to New York last year. No, this year. Was it this year? Can't remember. I think it was this year. Invited me to New York to shoot some promotional images for him. Being asked to go to another country to do your craft is the biggest testimonial you can ever have. And if you have that passion, I swear to God, you will get there, okay? If you want something hard enough, you will get there, I promise. I promise. You don't have to go to grammar school. I made it. You can too, I promise. Another thing you can do is work with charities. So I worked with a charity called Take Heart Mersey Mission. The way I got that, let me just fire up the pictures. I worked with a charity called Take Heart Mersey Mission, which involved working with a group of doctors, surgeons and nurses who every year go to Sri Lanka in Gaul, and they perform very delicate pediatric heart surgery. And the guy who runs it is Paul Scally, who owns Gillingham Football Club. And I met him when I was filming an interview with him for something completely different. And he said, I've got no one to film it this year. And I said, I'll film it. So I went to Sri Lanka. The second time I ever met Paul Scally, I met him at Colombo Airport because he met me from Dubai. So I went there and I filmed his documentary. And in between, I was photographing other pieces as well. So I'm hugely proud of this portfolio of images that I've taken in Sri Lanka. I hope you can see that okay. And yeah, if you work with charities, they can take you to places like this. And I'm going back there next month to carry on our documentary. And we're using it as a commissioned piece for the BBC to hopefully in 2016, the BBC will go out there and basically do what I've done, but we're using my video as a promotional piece, if that makes sense, to commission it. But in between, I shot these photographs. And I believe I'm wrapping up. People want to know, how much do you earn? How much do you earn? Well, as a freelance photographer, it's hard to say because, you know, how long's a piece of string? If as a freelancer, you earn your own wage, so it's hard to tell. If you work in banking, you know, there's a certain level of, you know, how much you earn, but with photography, it's kind of different. So it depends how much you charge, really. I'm at my stage, I'm earning about between 15 and 20 grand a year, which doesn't sound like a huge amount, but I love what I do. And last year, I was earning half that. Thanks to my retainership with Simon Cowell's label, I'm now earning a little bit more. But last year, I was earning half that. But I still absolutely loved my job. It's not about the money. I don't care about the money. I just love what I do. I love that I'm meeting new people every day. I'm working on something different and I'm learning every day. I literally have the best job in the world and I don't care what anyone else says. I have the best job in the world. I absolutely love what I do. I think I'm about wrapped up. Does anyone have any questions at all? Come on, there's got to be one. Yes. Yes, they do. Yeah. I got a free trip to New York and Sri Lanka and. Sorry. I went to China on business class this year. That was amazing. There's a funny story about that. I only just made the plane because I just took some shots for Ben Sherman, and when I was at the airport, I had to edit them really quickly and send them off before getting on a plane to go to China to do some shots with Jack Pack over there. And I was editing them really quickly and had to send them off, but the plane was boarding and I couldn't leave the Wi-Fi zone. So I had to really quickly edit them and wait for them to send via WeTransfer. And when it finally sent, slammed the laptop down, put it in my bag and ran as fast as I could. And I was so out of breath and I just made it to the gate. And when I said, wait, and she turned around and went, Reynolds. And I said, yes, I'm here. And I just got on the plane and everyone clapped me as I got on the plane because I only just made it. And the steward was like, would you like a drink? I said, yeah, yes, please. And I just made it, which is good. But
any final questions?
Unfortunately, no, I don't.
The message that you should have got from Tommy, obviously, is a man up here that absolutely loves his job. But more importantly, we've got to go back to Tommy's beginnings, and actually he was sat right where you are, just a few years ago. The message that I take from that is that Tommy got himself a good level of education in order to go on to sixth form. Okay? You couldn't go on and do media and photography without those five ATCs back then.
Absolutely.
Including English and maths. So there's one stage in order to go on to sixth form. And then in order to get his A-levels and go on to university, he needed to do sixth form. So education played a part in that too. It doesn't matter, lads, what you want to do in your future. Having your education, what that will do is give you choices. Choices of, oh, which sixth form shall I go to? Which university shall I go to with my qualifications? You then choose what you're going to study, but education is what arms you to go and get the dream that you want. I'm sure we would love to really show Tommy our appreciation, giving up his time and coming in and speaking to you all. So thank you very much.
I would just like to say one final thing. The teachers that taught me, some of them are still here. So you can still get the same level and the same exact teaching that I got, if not better, from people like Mr. Thompson, who taught me photography, Mr. Batchelor, who taught me media, Mr. Wise, who taught me music and helped me in his organization, Training Them Live. They're all still here. And I think they're absolutely amazing teachers. And they, without them, I wouldn't be here.